Welcome back to the adventure. Today we are repairing the automatic update feature in Windows Home Server. Here we are back at the server we set up in the previous video. To get started, we need to open New Moon. Then we need to locate the installer package for the C++ redistributable version 2012. Using the tool that installs all applicable versions of C++ is fine, however, for this we just need version 2012. Once that finishes installing, we need to source the installer package for Internet Explorer 8. I have received some feedback about not needing Internet Explorer for this to work. That is true because we're not getting the updates through the old Windows Update website. However, automatic updates will show Internet Explorer as an available update, and sometimes this causes the check for updates to take an extremely long time to complete. Once Internet Explorer 8 is installed and the system is rebooted, we need to install an update for Internet Explorer 8. Again, not required, but it is helpful to install it. With that out of the way, we can move on to downloading the Windows Update Mini Tool version 2016. What we get is a compressed file that contains the Windows Update Mini Tool. We can create a new folder on the desktop and extract the Mini Tool there. Last order of business is to get the patched PHP files. What we get is a compressed file that contains the patched PHP files, and some batch files that we can run. Create a second new folder on the desktop and extract the PHP files there. Now to open the new folder and double-click on Add WSUS. A command prompt window should appear, and we get the message that the operation completed successfully. Press any key to exit. Now to double-click on Run WSUS. If you get a prompt from the Windows firewall, click Unblock. Leave the command prompt window open, and then we can launch the Windows Update Mini Tool. Click on Check for Updates. We can see in the command prompt window there is some communication going on, which is good. It's talking to the Windows Update server like we want. After some time, the available updates will appear here in the right-hand pane of the Mini Tool. It looks like the installation disk I used for Windows Home Server didn't include any of the power packs, so we're going to want to install those. And I'm going to install the cumulative security update for Internet Explorer 8. A note about the Mini Tool, because it is in a foreign language, at least a language that's foreign to me. In the folder we extracted it to, there's another compressed file. We can open that and extract the INI file to the same folder. So now when we launch the Windows Update Mini Tool, the interface is in English. Also note that the automatic update feature in Windows Home Server itself is now functioning. That's it for repairing automatic updates in Windows Home Server. We had to install the C++ redistributable version 2012, followed by Internet Explorer 8, a patch for Internet Explorer 8, then use the Windows Update Mini Tool and patched PHP files to check for updates. Thanks for stopping by. See you next video.